Hey chat, I'm back. It was longer than 5 minutes, but whatever, man. Welcome back. We are now doing some actual drawing, as I've sent off everything to be proofed. Yeah, so let's go and find. So previously we were doing. See, I have slightly less. I mean, they're still a bit manky, but the COVID work stress nails have been slightly glitterfied. So last time we were working on doing some drawings in from GTA, and we got these two done, and I hated this one, which is less terrible than I had previously thought now looking at it. And then I had this one, which I thought was better. So I don't really know whether to continue to develop this one, or obviously what we can do is go for a look around in GTA and choose somewhere new, which might be an idea. I could try using a different technique. So rather than using the crayons, which I was previously using, which I love these, they're awesome, the Neo colors, I could go back to just using tonal stuff, which could be an interesting change. Let me just find, here's the high. Shove that up there. Okay, so something I worked out last time was that, let me just change that slightly. I worked out last time was that if I'm gonna be in this space, so looking at this on my monitor in game, well, in the world rather than in the game, because this doesn't have pedestrians or cars or anything like that, it's just me looking around the structures. And I want to draw from that, then I need to work out what I want to do in the sense of, I'm just repeating myself again. It's so hard for me to keep track of my intention because I'm sort of talking to nobody apart from bots or occasionally a human being. And that's hard because I lose my train of thought because I'm looking at multiple things at the same time whilst trying to narrate what I'm doing. Anyway, let's keep going. So I need to stay in one space. So I can break things, but I just need to approach it as if I was actually in the world and then try and draw from that. So I can break things, but I need to maybe consider more taking one perspective and then squashing it all together. Rather than these ones, what I was doing is obviously from here and here, I was breaking it. Actually, this one, both of them were for one perspective, but something about it, I don't know. So maybe what we can do this time is we can just do tritonal ink one. So I've got my watery pens. So some slightly manky tissue, I think has chocolate on it, but that'll be fine. So let's go and find somewhere. Can you see that? You can see that. Where should we go, chat? Let's change my angle. Oh yeah, because we discovered the bunker last time. Let's maybe go and look at the bunker, which is over by the docks, I think. So where was it? It was over here. Says confidently. Mm-hmm. Where has it gone? I think it was, there we go. Okay, so it needs to load in. So we've got a warehouse under here. All right, let's just wait for it to pop in. There we go. Okay, let me just print screen that. This part of the casino or something. It's extremely weird. Like a missile silo, but not. Okay, so I can't walk around in here as a pedestrian, alas. Okay, so here is my shooting range, which, can you not even get into it? That's so odd. So you everything is just weird. So where is the shooting range? Is it in here? So presumably you go through a door and then it whoops you. Then this is here. It's very odd. The geographies of everything sort of being smooshed together. All right, so let's find a spot and park ourselves. Sadly, the cool lighting that they have in here isn't active, which I don't think there's a way that I can get that to happen. What do you do here? On the wall in the bunker. Let's see if I can avoid getting motion sickness, but I can already feel that happening. It's not very helpful. a bit broken. Is it capturing my cursor? No, it's not. Let me just change that. Give me one sec. Let's just go to properties. Capture cursor, please. Okay. Okay, now you can see my cursor. It seems quite broken. Okay. Let me just have some ASMR cracking. Doesn't really do it. Try playing around with the lighting a bit. Actually, without the shadows on, that looks better. Okay. Can you actually see what I'm doing, chat? You kind of can. So I guess I'm kind of drawing to develop it into something else, maybe. What that something else is, I'm not sure. It's the whole thing of, should I draw using the pen? Or should I be using my pencil? Or something else? Let's print screen this. Okay, that's the first yawn of the stream. Okay. Just move my monitor a little bit. Try not to draw on my... Ooh. Hold on a minute. Give me 1 second. as my entire setup collapses.
Thank you.
Okay, chat. Sorry about that. I was baffing around. Please stop pinging into that position, Mr. Window. I was working on getting, so my camera was falling over and all of that jazz, and well, it wasn't falling over. I took it out, so I have an Elgato arm. What's it called? I can't even remember. Anyway, it's really good, but obviously it has a lot of sort of ball and socket joints. So you have to get it really, really tight and sort of, and I didn't. And I have to set up my camera every time I stream because I don't have a separate space. So I took these off, which you can't even see. And then my camera, as I complained about it the other day, it needs tilting so that it doesn't automatically switch into a different formatting. So there's that as well. Just put these back together so I don't lose them. All right. So yeah, that's the part of the arm, which I would recommend if you need something that's kind of versatile, but yeah. Okay, hopefully we can now do some drawing without everything falling over, she says confidently. Okay, where was I? Let's do VidScreen. I go back to this. Okay. So how much of this can you actually see? Stuff over here, okay. So again, it feels really artificial because I can't draw as I would usually draw, because I don't have the space. I'd usually be a lot closer to where I'm drawing. But it is what it is. So yeah, what was I talking about? I can't remember. Something clearly really vital. I'm just watching to see if my light is falling over again. So I have a ring light with the camera in the middle. The camera's here. Hello, camera. And we've got the ring light that goes around the edge, which I don't know whether you can kind of see, but yeah, it goes around here. So the ring light's kind of at eye level, and then I have my mic off to the side, which is kind of off to this side. And yeah, it's all quite... One way to describe it would be bijou, I suppose. Yeah, so I can't... We're going to do a short stream because I'm going to need to get some food in a bit. But, I mean, that's two streams in a day, man. Exciting times. So I need to actually do some drawing. So I guess if I'm drawing with this, then it's, you can't rub stuff out. You can just sort of work over the top, which forces you to kind of work less preciously, is always, I think, a good thing. Except I do like the drawing I did previously. So, I don't know. Let's just do it. Let's just go for it and stop faffing around. So again, so not being too precious about what I'm doing. Just to get the drawing done. Which makes it sound like a chore, which it isn't, but that's just how I'm choosing to work with it. Sort of working quickly. Build up some sort of drawing. Oh, look, unintentional phalluses. Great. Great. Tricky, and I'm having to and turn my head and looking at my page to my monitor. I suppose the way to think about this is the how I'm drawing reflects how my eye moves. Sort of stuff that I find interesting is what I then draw. So the sort of swooshing of everything together kind of reflects that. Everything feels like it's a slight wonky lean. distance. So again, not being overly precious about stuff. Trying to put in the main, I don't know, sort of just highlight where the differences of stuff areas are, I guess. A little bit too wet. Kind of like the kind of smoosh there. Again, this is not good art, but it's okay. It's a process, chat. Clearly, it is a process. It's because I'm drawing with a big fat pen. Things don't look great. Oh, it's more magic sword. I was thinking, this is good. What is it? Stop myself from getting too precious about it. This magic sword is very, very similar to a track from Man. Manhunter. Not Manhunter? Oh my god, I've just like had a brain. Brain freeze. Yeah, Manhunter. So I know I can totally overdo this kind of washed up. Absolutely overdo it. So you have to move quite quickly because when you stop, it dries, or at least it doesn't run as much. So that in itself can give quite interesting effects when you can feel the difference. Twitch chat has eyes, yay! I'm trying to untangle the areas that I've got, so what was meant to be going here? Do these. Yeah, I hate it less. Way. Actually hate something less. Woohoo! I mean, this has got some quite. It's also still wet, but you'll see this Twitch chat. Get this nice area down here. Maybe this is too boring a view, or it's the fat pen. It's probably the fat pen. Am I still? Oh no, I'm wave shaper. I'm doing the pondering thing, chat. The pondering thing. Just tilt that. The pondering thing. So I could add some crayon. What is this? This is silver grey. So some crayon over the top. Particularly as it is still damp or wet, would potentially look quite good. Again, I'm being too precious about it. Okay, let me just photograph this. What is the point of what I'm doing here? And is this going to become something else? Am I going to develop this further? Which I tend not to do. I tend just to sort of do a thing and then it's done. So if I'm not going to develop this into anything else, I need to do something with it, rather than just leave it. I can feel I'm hungry. I'm hungry. Let's try. If I take this edge off. Obviously, this is now sort of a different tone or quality or colour. Underlying washes. This was a mistake. Somehow the tone, the warmth of the coolness isn't quite right. Maybe it's the scale of things, the scale of the mark making that I can do with these versus the rest of the drawing doesn't kind of work. Which I can obviously semi do something about by this. I end up doing what I want to do, undoubtedly. That I hate less now.
Hate it less.
Yay! I'll actually be able to have here. I'm not entirely sure. Slating it? Hating it slightly less. Time we're going here. Just what we want, really. To have like an automatic post. I think I'm gonna get some food chat and maybe come back later or come back tomorrow so I can have a break from things as I'm hungry. Let's do that. Okay. I am going to end things there and I will return either later today or tomorrow. Thank you so much for hanging out. Really do appreciate it. And hope that you have a good rest of your morning or afternoon or evening or wherever. Yeah, it's dark. 5 o'clock now and I need to get some food. Yes, thank you for hanging out. Really appreciate it.